According to a new report from the Wall Street Journal, the Trump family, Donald Trump, Don Jr., Eric, Ivanka, you know, the ones who run the Trump organization, they're actually facing, once Trump daddy president leaves office, they're facing a major, what they're calling a cash crunch. And that means that even though the organization may be wealthy, they are cash poor. A lot of people, myself included, are very familiar with that. You know, on paper, sure, you got a decent income, things look great, but you're cash flow poor. Meaning all your money is already tied up into other things, you know, debts, things like that. And that's the problem, according to the Wall Street Journal, that the Trump organization is facing. The problem with that, and I had actually predicted this 2 weeks ago, I said this exact thing would happen, and now it's being confirmed that it's happening. The problem with this is that they got hundreds of millions of dollars in debt that is coming due within months of Donald Trump no longer being president of the United States. They have to pay those debts. Banks are not willing to lend them more money to pay off those debts, which is kind of what typically happens. It's the debt cycle that these massive corporations create for themselves because they don't necessarily need to pay it off because they have the credit to be able to get the loan to pay off that loan. Then they get a loan to pay off this loan and blah, 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 and around and around it goes. Eventually they pay it off, they pay it down, whatever, but they don't have to do it immediately. But Trump will. Because even before he became president, banks weren't exactly willing to lend him money. That's why he had to go to these overseas banks, Deutsche Bank. But after watching the scrutiny, and this has also been reported in the recent weeks, watching the scrutiny that Deutsche Bank has received, they're not willing to extend the deadlines on his loan or lend him more money. Other banks are looking at this saying, well, we don't want to have to turn over all our stuff to investigators, so we're not going to touch him. So he only has one option. And this is what I predicted a couple weeks ago, and it's coming true. He has to sell stuff. When you're in the real estate business, your money is tied up in buildings. That's what happens. You sell it or you rent it, whatever you're doing, and then you get money. And then you use that money, you go do the other thing. And then you use the same thing here and you get money and you go do more and you blah, 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 blah. But your money is always basically tied up except for what you've taken out as a profit. And what you've taken out as a profit is now in your pocket, in your bank account. You're not going to use that to pay off your company's debts. And so you end up having to sell your buildings. Right now, Donald Trump and the Trump organization have multiple buildings up for sale, including the DC hotel, by the way. It's for sale. They just can't afford it. They have multiple properties that they are co-owners of. Skyscraper in New York, one in San Francisco, for sale. Please, somebody come buy this building because we need the cash to pay off the debts. If they do not pay off these debts, as the Wall Street Journal reports, you're going to start looking at some seizures. You know, the bank kind, where they come and say, well, you owe us $400 million. We're within our legal right to take $400 million from you. And if it's all tied up in real estate, we'll take it that way. Cash, check, or building, whatever it is, we're getting our money back. That's in the agreement that you signed. So they are within their rights, if he is unable to pay these debts by the time they come due, to start taking his buildings away from him. And then, again, as I predicted, because we've seen this happen in areas before, think Panama, they ceremoniously tear down that Trump name off the building, smash it to bits. That would be a fitting end to the Trump legacy. And if these reports are to believe, it's a lot more likely than a lot of people think.